Now, I want to debunk some of this, you know, some of this, I would say, Chicken Little arguments on how if we would close the coal plants, it would cause catastrophic effects for the energy supply on the island. AES can close tomorrow while keeping the lights on and preventing price increases on the island.
Energy is the industry that powers every other industry. The lower cost and more reliable energy is, the lower cost and more reliable everything is, and vice versa. And I just want to stress that Puerto Rico's energy situation is terrible. And one of the reasons I want to testify today is nobody is talking about that. They're talking about how do we maintain the status quo? The status quo is terrible in Puerto Rico. It desperately needs more low-cost, reliable energy. And just as one more comment, it doesn't seem like anybody here knows the actual facts. So I just want to stress what percentage right now, I cannot believe, I mean, I'm really disappointed that Representative Ocasio-Cortez talks about shutting down the coal plant tomorrow. I don't know if anyone knows what percentage of renewables the whole island is. So it's 2.5%. I mean, this is so disappointing that we're talking about this so unseriously. So we really need to highlight the value of low cost, reliable energy and really talk about why Puerto Rico needs much more of it. I don't mean to pick on Representative Ocasio-Cortez, but she tweeted the infrastructure's failures in Texas are quite literally what happens when you don't pursue a Green New Deal. No, in fact, plenty of places around the world can deal with hot and cold when they have enough reliable, resilient electricity. Texas defunded reliable, resilient electricity, including winterization, to pay tens of billions of dollars for unreliable solar and wind that don't work when you need them the most. This is really, you want to talk about an existential threat? This energy policy is an existential threat to the U.S. And I mean, unbelievable. I mean, it would make Puerto Rico into truly a consistently third world country.